grand state visit of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and His Royal Highness Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, to Jamaica. JBC Radio 1 and JBC Television bring you coverage, live and recorded highlights of this historic visit.
Good Queen Bess is here again for the fourth time in her reign. Happy voices swell the strain. Welcome to our Queen. So most welcome, Lady Dear. We rejoice to have you here. Raise we now the gladsome chair.
Well, they're hoping it will be ready in time. 2 days, and then they can do a lot of work in 2 days.
I am preparing the luncheon at Jamaica House. We had to send all the menus up to Buckingham Palace for approval, and they were all approved. This is a chilled cucumber soup that we're making, and the base of it is fresh yogurt. And lots of chives, chopped cucumbers, lemon juice, and a few other ingredients that I'd rather not disclose. Christmas tree with all those colours. This looks nice on you. Or would you rather wear a blazer? No, I think this is nice.
No, I don't want to wear a blazer.
Okay, so we're going to go through the same thing again. Okay, here we go. One blazer and a pair of grey slacks. Okay, try to hold them up against you. Let's see. That'll be fine.
Philip, my dear. Last night I thought was you in here. Where did you go? Working for good old England, missing out all the action. My dear, do you know? There was a man in my bed.
Did you know that in January 1949, Princess Alice, Countess of Athlone, was appointed the first Chancellor of the University of the West Indies?
Thank you very much, Andrew.
You're welcome, Your Majesty.
Very nice, I thought. Very good. So what are you going to tell the Queen if she asks what's in the box?
When she asks me what.
What is this, Andrew? What are you going to say?
I'm not going to tell her.
No?
I'm not going to tell her.
What are you going to say?
She's going to have to open it by herself.
Radio 1 will begin today at 5 o'clock with a feature on royal visits to Jamaica, followed by the live broadcast of the arrival and welcome ceremony at the Norman Manley International Airport and Her Majesty's journey to King's House. Her Majesty the Queen is greeted by the Governor General of Jamaica, His Excellency, the Most Honourable Sir Florizel Augustus Glasspool, O.M., G.C.M.G., C.D., L.L.D.
Guinness Jamaica Limited, bottlers of ting, Jamaica Golden Medal, good for drink. Welcome for Majesty. Welcome to Ting Country.
Feeling of hushed anticipation as the crowds gathered here await the arrival of Her Majesty the Queen.
Here comes Queen!
And there they come. Her Majesty is wearing a blue floral chiffon dress.
In Kingston, the ladies' hairdressers report such heavy booking that they have had to disappoint many ladies urgently seeking appointments. Ladies' dressmakers have also been doing a roaring trade.
Thank you.
Princess Anne celebrated her 16th birthday in Jamaica in August 1966?
This is for Prince Williams from the Children of Jamaica.
Yes, I wouldn't say Queen Elizabeth, I would say Your Majesty.
Your Majesty, this is for...
This is a gift for Prince William from the Children of Jamaica.
This, Your Majesty, this is a gift for Prince William from the Children of Jamaica.
Done by Father Hart, who is the executive director of the Institute of Jamaica, and loaned for this occasion. Floral decorations in the master bedroom, again of the time. A very ingenious combination of almost wild roses, very pale pink wild roses. From the master bedroom, the royal party will move into what is termed the ladies' sewing room. A charming example of a sewing room of that period, where there are sewing boxes, there is needlepoint, all the various accoutrements that a lady...
She lets just us three who are recently here.
That
was promised for us.
Not for you, for the three.
No, for the three of us.
Can't work. What I'm the local.
And whoever can.
The local.
The local has been having their way all the time.
They come first, and the UK photographers second.
Can I ask you once more, press, to get back a little bit?
How far?
Back to about where he is.
Okay, here we go.
It is a bedspread for Prince William.
Isn't that kind?
Welcome, Your Majesty.
Bedspread? Isn't that lovely? Were you there yesterday when we came to lunch?
Yes.
That's very kind.
This afternoon, when the Queen arrives at the National Stadium, there is a grand cultural display that has been planned for her. And we'll have a group of Maroons from Moortown in the northeastern section of the island, led by Colonel Harris. And you remember the Maroons held out against the British. They ran to the hills, stayed there as runaway slaves, and fought there very many battles.
We are going to go to the stadium to pay our respects to the Queen. Mind you, she may never see us very closely because the stadium is a big place. But then, if we'll understand that nobody could compel us to go there if we didn't want to. We are going there because we have all the love in our heart for her.
Hello,
come. The float. So we're hoping that the float, which is going to be coming right after this, will come in on time.
One line.
You can do it now?
Yes.
All right, go quickly.
All right, do it now.
Yacht.
Remember the balloons. Remember the balloons.
We're going around twice. We're going around twice. Remember the balloons.
Balloons. What about the balloons?
They have to go with that.
Oh, where's the man in charge? Sir, were you told that they are supposed to stay on?
No, they're coming off.
You're going to make them come off?
We're going very well. My God, the worst is over.
I can't believe it.
Out about a dance there. What is going on? That's a rude dance.
We have the mass bugle bands.
Yes.
We should finish by 10 to 5.
Yes.
So the Queen will get her rest. She's due back at King's House at 5 o'clock, you see.
So I think we're going great.
We're in fine.
Oh, you must be relieved. Oh, God. You have no idea.
The Queen went on her way bearing gifts, coffee beans, cigars, one quilt, one paper knife, two candlesticks, a book of Jamaican flowers, a book on Jamaican houses, one silk picture, and a bottle of rum.
There she is. Maybe you can hear some of the 3,000 people who have gathered here to get a glimpse of the Queen. The first time a reigning monarch will ever have set foot in California.
She looks lovely. Just lovely. Pictures don't do her justice. They make her look heavy, and she's just a little bitty petite thing.
Bill Cleeter did a don't. He touched Queen Elizabeth II. The acting mayor of San Diego probably thought he was being friendly when he gently placed his hand on the Queen's back to guide her. A British history expert said one does not touch royals. The maximum touch is a handshake. You don't put your arm around her. It's a horrendous social gaffe.
California, where the rain doesn't rain, it just drizzles champagne, California.
The Queen wanted to see a Hollywood studio. The finest old-time studio lot still operating is 20th Century Fox, and First Lady Nancy has invited 500 over for dinner on Soundstage 9, a vast space where the MASH series was filmed.
Protocol calls for anyone meeting the Queen to curtsy. Sheila Schnegg, president of the Sierra Madre British Home, is giving curtsy lessons. She is well acquainted with royal protocol, as she was presented at court at Buckingham Palace in 1979 to receive the MBE.
I love this dress. This is my favorite dress.
Breathe in.
The only thing is it's short.
She's never seen me in this one.
Okay, done.
What do you think, Jo?
Kira, that's lovely.
But it's short.
It's short.
Well, I mean, love it. Right. I adore this dress.
The colour's perfect. It's royal purple, but it's short. An invitation, red, long dress.
Well, okay, you're in it.
Okay.
Ooh, yes, you've lost a lot of weight.
Okay, I have to wear this over it. I don't know. Let's see. It's about 4 years old, this dress.
Looks a bit like a curtain.
But
oh, look.
What do you think?
Yeah. Natasha, what do you think?
Natasha, what do you think of this, darling?
It looks like you're getting married.
Do you think so?
My good luck piece, you know. When I was at the Royal Ballet with Dr. Armin Hammer, Prince Charles was introduced to me by doctor, and he saw this piece, and he said, what an extraordinary piece of jewelry. And I just said, well, thank you, sir. And he said, what is a stone? And I said, it's glass, sir. And he said, glass? And of course, Dr. Hammer then explained what I did. And my good fortune because if it hadn't been that precise moment, I never would have gotten the commission to do the wedding gift to Prince Charles and Lady Di, and I did for them a horse's head with a little golden mane. Princess Diane said it was in their bedroom.
Am I all intact?
Yeah, how am I in the back?
You should have a little more swish up there, whatever you do with that.
I can only say that I have had calls and calls and calls, and people said, how did you happen to be invited? And I cannot tell you the noses that are out of joint, the people that are unhappy, that said, I can't understand not being invited. But they only can handle 500. Whatever happens, we don't dare be late.
This skirt is a bit too much with it, actually.
Oh, no, are you kidding? They're going to be dressed up like, I don't know what.
That's great.
What do you think, Jo?
Pretty. I love that.
This is quite beautiful, this
That's
dress.
That's absolutely beautiful.
Do you think the skirt is too much?
Well, try without.
Because
let's see without. What do you think, Natasha?
I think she should wear this dress.
It's too revealing.
No? You don't think so?
I like it.
Why don't you go show Michael?
Okay, I'm going to go and show Michael. Where is Michael? It's us. Michael, what do you think?
We've got a choice, have we?
Yeah.
I like that.
Here's the royal one, but it's short.
This is what I love.
Mrs. Reagan said long dresses, didn't she? Isn't that right?
Yes,
so
she did.
What about the one Natasha has?
I love that, too.
I think that's great.
Do you?
Yeah.
I love it, but it's a bit too revealing. Daddy wouldn't like that.
They're smashing that white one,
see,
yeah.
You like that white one?
Yeah, but I've never seen that on. Is that
new? Oh, I've worn that before, Michael. That dress is 4 years old.
It looks as though she's getting married.
Don't drop myself in it here.
It's a bit wedding-y.
It is a bit wedding. I suppose if that one's too bright, the one Natasha's got is too revealing, we're left with that one, which is great.
But how do you address the Queen and Prince Philip?
Prince Philip, Your Royal Highness. And then after that, it's Ma'am and Sir forevermore. Until you go away and come back, then you start all over again.
You'll be sitting very close to her tonight.
Yes, but you don't shout across the table. You? You've got to be sitting next to them to speak to them.
We don't have royalty. And royalty is like a fairy story to us. We read it as a little children about the king and the queen and the prince and princesses. And we don't have any. So she's really everyone's queen in a way.
Hello, ladies. I've got some royal tips for you. Should you be invited to sup with the Queen, remember the British dab their mouths with napkins. Americans wipe theirs. Also, Americans at the end of meals tend to be surrounded by wadded-up napkins. No genteel Englishman would produce a crinkled napkin at the end of a meal. Theirs are dauntingly free of wrinkles.
Let me see. Newley, Hussey, Hopkins,
Elton John,
Stewart,
Garson.
Well, which Stewart, James or Rod?
Rod, I was thinking Rod. Philip, Julie Andrews, Dudley Moore, James Seymour, Rod Stewart.
Thank you very much.
Do you have any advice for some of these other people about meeting the Queen for the first time?
Yes, be yourself. Be yourself, that's what you've got to be. Just be, don't put on any act, because she's seen them all.
When you meet the Queen?
Do you think we've talked to enough of them?
I'm sorry about the weather, though.
It was certainly one of the most lavish productions ever staged here at 20th Century Fox Studios, and certainly a night nobody will ever forget. Robin Leach, Entertainment Tonight.
Without you, it certainly
tried. You could do better than that, Robin.
Go.
It was certainly one of the most lavish productions ever staged at 20th Century Fox Studios.
The Queen was in white chiffon with orange Californian poppies on the bodice.
Productions ever staged at the 20th Century Fox Studios, and although it will never... It was one of the most lavish productions.
The dress was designed by Hardy Amis, who is a guest.
At the age of 79, I became a dramatic actor. And I found out the most important thing about acting is honesty. And if you can fake that, you got it made.
Thank you.
from Idaho because I'm related.
You are related, huh?
9 generations. I'm the same line of descent as Prince Charles from the House of Saxe-Coburg.
When she was coronated, my mother and I slept on the sidewalk.
So you're here to see her again,
huh? Yes.
Okay, here we go, folks. Here she comes.
It was good stuff. If I couldn't see my glasses, my
view. Your glasses or your lens, right?
Well, it was all three, I think. It's just depends on how much.
I'm getting soaked.
I'm just going to put it in a mess, okay?
That's normal, Doc. Oh.
Well, I hope you got enough so that it's going to be worthwhile.
Well.
The storm to hit the California coast this winter is dumping heavy rains along the Pacific coast this morning.
The Villa Rosa Hotel is on the waterfront. The Queen of England will be anchoring just outside our door. A Villa Rosa Harbor View with king-size bed is about $100. Phone 966-0851 at 966.
Color it with more than a touch of fantasy. Add a dash of childhood dreams. Mix in moments of spiritual reflection, and you have a travel experience that could rival My Fair Lady. With Queen Elizabeth II as your guide. Queen Elizabeth plans to go horseback riding with the president just as he did at her castle in England. You can get the same feel by renting a horse from Gene O'Hagan's Stables, right next door to the Reagan's Ranch. Phone 805-968-5929. That's 805-968-5929.
Said Nancy, who feels the week's trials have brought her closer to the Queen, the whole week has become an adventure instead of a state visit.
So instead of the planned spectacular arrival of the Queen sailing underneath the Golden Gate Bridge, the royal party will take an Air Force jet this afternoon. For National Public Radio, this is Steve Futterman.
Her floating palace temporarily abandoned, the Queen is moving into the 31st floor of the St. Francis Hotel in San Francisco. The change has caused the St. Francis to push the panic button to prepare the royal suite. The Queen has brought her own water. A huge vat of the Malvern Worcestershire water she carries on Britannia was seen being taken up to her room.
We were not anticipating the Queen coming. That's basically what the problem is. So we're just trying to make it more comfortable for her. More feminine. This is probably one of the most masculine suites we have. And we're just trying to soften it up a little bit for her. Soft touches, flowers, plants, and knickknacks.
All right, then we need ashtrays like brass or something in here.
Where are those chunky ones?
Look in my cabinet and see if you have any other brass in the way of any plates or stuff like that. I think we're pretty well cleaned out. The botanical prints, the pictures that were hanging over the beds in the main room. Okay. Give me a sample.
Down just a little bit.
A little bit.
There.
Yeah, not really.
Well, that gives them a chance to see themselves.
Take the last look.
Okay.
Will the blue plates go?
I don't know. Which chairs do you like? Take these out. I think these are better looking chairs. Put the red apples over there. We've got it.
So it's done.
Well, what do you think? I think it looks more comfortable.
Yeah.
Very, very enjoyable, despite the flooding.
If there are no further questions. Yes.
Do you know what type of dinner they're having tonight?
I have no idea whatsoever.
Tonight's menu for 250 guests includes lobster tureen with golden caviar and dill sauce, double consommé of pheasant, quenelles of goose liver, loin of veal with morel mousse with balsamic vinegar sauce, served with truffled potatoes, asparagus tips wrapped in endive leaves.
Is it a special honor for you to prepare a meal like this?
Well, there's no question.
Director of Catering Todd Carter said it is an honor to be entrusted with the challenge of catering out the state dinner. The hotel's most interesting cater-out site to date was Alcatraz, where a cell block was transformed into a dining hall for a police athletic league benefit.
Lots of telling.
break the royal visit, Mr. Betterer proudly presents A Prince of a Meal, featuring a Philip of Coca-Cola and a Duke of Edinburgh and chips, all for
$1.95. Okay. Okay. Girls, attention. Scout sign. Okay. We're going to go over what is going to hopefully happen with us today, okay? And of course, everybody remembers that I'm Thumper. Yes. The Queen of England is the patron of Girl Scouts all over the world. So we are honoring her because she is our patron. And what would we give the Queen but
cookies?
I have got here one of every variety of Girl Scout cookies. And we're going to present those, so maybe she can nibble on the boat on the way home. Clover is getting out daisies for each of you girls, so that if we are in a group and the Queen passes by, we may wave our daisies at her as a form of a salute. What are some of the things you don't do when you go to see a Queen? Huh? Can I see everybody take the little flower that they have in their hand, since everybody has one? And you would bow your head and...
Your Majesty.
Okay. And you hold your head down and hold your hands out until it's accepted. Unless darkness comes and we all go home and go to bed.
The time is now 19 minutes past the hour.
The San Francisco Police Department made no apologies for the security surrounding the St. Francis Hotel. They remember it was at this very same corner that Lynette Alice Fromm tried to take a shot at the then President Gerald Ford back in 1975.
Go ahead, Central Command.
May we?
No.
We may not?
No.
Where may we go? I have 22 Girl Scouts that would very much like to see the Queen. They have daisies, banners, and flags, and they've been preparing quite a long time for it.
Here comes the President.
On the sidewalk. Everyone on the sidewalk.
I don't even know where the rest of my party is. Everyone with the banners and the flags, gone. I don't know where they are.
All right, here she comes, the Queen.
The important thing is that there were no incidents of any kind.
And then there were the gifts. A pair of porcelain pelicans, a ship's bell, a model space shuttle, a kilt for Prince William, four dog magnets, one rocking horse, a fishing fly, a jelly bean picture of the Queen, 30 pounds of shrimps, three musical bears, and a book of sea slugs.
Thank you.
will arrive in Victoria, Canada on March 9th. Everything from recycled royal wedding leftovers to limited edition prints and fine gold is gracing the windows of the Victoria merchants to cash in on the royal tour. Books on the Queen's tour are already available, even though it hasn't happened yet, said Barry Giles in charge of stationery. Asked how they could be prematurely produced, he said, it's happened before.
League is just a tiny bit miffed. In Victoria, Molly Ingram, chairman of the local branch, pleaded with tour officials for a special location for the more than 500 members of the branch to see the Queen, but she was politely turned down. Said Molly, I once chatted to the Queen for 15 wonderful minutes.
I feel that I would like to swear allegiance to the crown, not to some flag. And I feel that it is a symbol of the very best of Canadian ideals and everything, particularly when it's embodied in our marvelous, very gracious, and most gallant Queen of Canada.
17,000 British Columbians are expected to take tea served in gold styrofoam cups on the legislature lawn. Commemorative tea bags will be on sale. Details of that and other stories right after this word from our sponsor.
The weather in Victoria.
Beautiful.
In February and March is beautiful. Always. Right?
Right.
Beautiful.
What's the forecast for tomorrow?
Terrible. It's not rain.
Entertaining Her Majesty when she arrives in Victoria will be Carol Moner, Herman Burging from Holland. Back in 1958, only a month after taking over the Centennial Carillon, Mr. Burgink unfortunately shut himself in his bell tower. It was some hours before passers-by realized his predicament.
I do a real curtsy. I mean, you know, you bend down as far as you possibly can, and I will attempt to go as far as I possibly can if there's any hope of seeing the Queen. I would love to come to the lunch, but I wasn't invited.
I wasn't able to curtsy to her because she was too far away.
Columbia's Museum of Anthropology, a group of Kwakiutl Indians from Fort Rupert will perform fertility dances in the gracious presence of Her Majesty the Queen and His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh.
Thank you.
Pleated dress in
Jack,
what?
How do you spell?
Pleated dress in matching crepe de chine, C-R-E-P-E.
What's that? It's the material.
It's a kind of material.
Oh. Yeah, dress fashion experts.
Chine, C-H-I-N-E.
Okay.
Boater.
Is that a hat?
And burnt straw, trimmed with navy velvet ribbon. And the designer is Hardy Amies, A-M-I-E-S.
Matching pleated dress.
Boater hat.
Crepe de
chine.
What's that?
China. It's a special
it's material.
Kind of
China,
material.
Yeah. You made your own dresses. You know what that means?
A matching dress.
John Osman reports from the quayside. I've been on the whole of this tour, and she's just pulled people out by their thousands everywhere. Not only in the three countries which she reigns over, Jamaica and the Cayman Islands.
We do have about eight contestants for the Queen Elizabeth look-alike contest here tonight. We're going to give
she
you a little show.
With her many gifts, which included some painted stones, a skin scroll, a gold frog pin, a pine sapling, some tea, a peace pipe, a clay raccoon. We'll have details on this story and others right after this word from our sponsor.
You've got enough so that it's going to be worthwhile.
People out by their thousands everywhere, not only in the three countries which she reigns over, Jamaica and the Cayman Islands.
We do have about eight contestants for the Queen Elizabeth look-alike contest here tonight. We're going to give
she
you a little show.
With her many gifts, which included some painted stones, a skin scroll, a gold frog pin, a pine sapling, some tea, a peace pipe, a clay raccoon. We'll have details on this story and others right after this word from our sponsor.
Got enough so that it's going to be worthwhile.